Good morning to all the dignitaries, honorable professors, teachers, postgraduate colleagues and students. I am Dr. Vinil Raj, first year postgraduate of forensic medicine from Government Medical College, Andhra. Today I am presenting case of mysterious deaths, either due to perversion or murder. Why I have titled this as because the crime scene photographs giving an impression of practice of suspicious death due to perversions like sexual asphyxia, whereas the postmortem examination and the postmortem examination and the thorough investigation of the police officer confirmed this case as homicide. So I titled it as mystery deaths, either due to perversion or murders. Hanging oneself is a deliberate act, but it has taken an unforeseen turn. Asphyxophilia is a bizarre sexual practice defined as a sexual game that consists of restricting the amount of oxygen to the brain in order to intensify sexual pleasure. It is a common practice in sadomasochistic setting and is potentially dangerous. The victims are almost always males and usually young or teenagers. The place of death is usually the person's house, either in the bedroom or bathroom or basement or any isolated area. The majority cases, doors may be locked or bolted from inside. Males with homosexual preferences tend to carry out these practices in pairs as a means of protection from phobia of accidental deaths. So, various methods such as partial hanging, plastic bag inhalation, overdressing or body wrapping in order to cause suffocation, and foreign body insertion and electric stimulation to genitalia, these are the various methods practiced. So, partial hanging, most frequent form seen in the sexual asphyxia. The neck is protected with a padding between the neck and the ligature. The ligature is passed around the neck in the form of a running noose. The free ends are attached to the limbs or any fixed object. The weight of the body is used to control the pressure over the neck. Plastic bag in which it is covering the head in a plastic or some impressive bag which may be secured around the neck by an elastic band or a ligature to achieve hypoxia. In some cases, the other end of the ligature is tied to the external genitalia. Sometimes soaked packs with one of the sniffing substances such as glue, ether, amyl nitrate may be found within the bag. Sexual gratification may be obtained by the electric stimulation by placing electrodes over genitalia with low voltage supply from a battery. So the reason behind the practice of asphyxia resulting to gratification is asphyxia, which causes hypoxia, in turn causes an increased carbon dioxide supply, carbon concentration in the arterial blood, which is utilized for the L-arginine metabolism, which causes release of nitrous oxide, which causes smooth muscle relaxation. In turn, it causes the ingress of the blood into the corpus cavernosum and corpus spongiosum, so it causes erection. Case report. Now I am going to tell what case was done in 2016. Mystery deaths given the suspicious death due to sexual asphyxia happened on 20th May 2016. Requisition received from the investigative officer of Atmakur police station on 21st May 2016 by 10 a.m. all the crime scene photographs. As per the inquest, on 20th May 2016, victim had carried money and gold from their house and also borrowed from their neighbours with a promise to return with high interest rates in a few hours and left home. They were last seen alive on 28 May 2016 at about 5 p.m. by family members and first seen dead on the same day by about 7:30 p.m. by the family members. Neighbor who resided next to the victim's workshop saw the entry of victim and three unknown persons in the house, and after some time only the unknown persons had left the home. He informed the same to the family members, and on complaint police registered the case and shifted the body to the mortuary of Government General Hospital in Ananthapuramu after taking photographs of the scene of crime with the deceased body. These are the photos of the deceased bodies, in which the person are tied in such a way that all the multiple rows of threads are to the all the extremities, and in turn it is attached to the neck, so it causes and a protective padding also observed between the neck and the ligature material. And articles found at the scene of crime include condoms, two towels, male chappals, female chappals, unopened food packet, hair clip and broken mangles and tabloid piece. So position of the bodies at the scene of crime and also the articles at the scene of crime giving an impression of that there was a practice of autolytic asphyxia which led to death, or it may be due to any sexual act done by any female person. So these are the conclusion given by the photographs. But whereas the postmortem findings, bodies are completely intact and semi-naked, eyes are partly closed and conjecture is congested, blue discoloration nail is present in both cases, mouth is partly open and dribbling of blood-tinged fluid from the angles of the mouth is seen in the second victim, and lemons are partly seen in the work cavities of the first victim. Later, the postmortem changes such as postmortem lividity is present over the back of the body, rigor mortis is present all over the body, putrefaction is not present externally. So injuries, no other injuries except a transverse ligature mark is present below the thyroid prominence and completely encircling the neck. Completely encircling ligature mark was abraded margins, dry, hard untouched and on parchment line. On dissection, underlying subdermal tissues and muscles are contused. Hide and thyroid part layers are intact in both cases. So these are the internal findings which concluded it as a homicide. Two full lemons present in the oropharynx and laryngopharynx and blocking the lumen of the larynx with surrounding splinter hemorrhages of the soft tissues in the first victim, and whereas in the second victim, one full and a half vinyl lemon was present in the oropharynx and laryngopharynx and blocking the lumen of the larynx with surrounding splinter hemorrhages of the soft tissues. So these are the lemons which obstructed the upper respiratory tract which caused death. So all visceral organs are intact and congested. Petechial hemorrhages are present over the mucosal surface of the organs. And blood investigations such as blood and viscera are preserved and sent for chemical analysis for any stupefying agents or any poisonous substance present there. And postmortem examination concluded on the same day by 1 pm. Opinion to the cause of death is triad of asphyxia is present in both cases. The approximate time of death is 12 to 18 hours prior to the postmortem examination. And opinion asphyxia resulting from ligature strangulation associated with blockade of upper respiratory passage. So this is the judgment recently given out. When I am preparing for this paper, I got this judgment in a newspaper article saying that the accused were convicted recently, that is on October 25th. So this is a paper article regarding that. And conclusion is, crimes in visit or its photographs giving some opinion towards cause and manner of the death. But sometimes reconstruct the crime with available scene of crime evidences may lead to misinterpretation of cause and manner of death. Meticulous autopsy aids in justifying opinion regarding cause and manner of the death, but exceptions are possible. My sincere thanks to my professor, Dr.